Shankara. I offer my deep reverence and humble obeisance to His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama. My respectful regards to Shri A.S. Kiran Kumar, Chairman of ISRO, Shri N.R. Panditaradhya, President Sheshadripuram Group of Institutions, and President of this auspicious function, honorary office bearers, life members and trustees of Sheshadripuram Institutions, heads of our institutions as well as other educational institutions, our staff, members of the press, invitees, parents and dear students. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning to you all and a very warm welcome to this program. I deem it a blessing to be in the presence of the august and divine presence of His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama. It is also a privilege for me to welcome you all. This is a unique moment in the history of Sheshadripuram institutions because the renowned and revered spiritual apostle of the world, His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama, has graciously condescended to impart a spiritual message on education in wisdom and compassion for nation building. This event is all the more memorable because four of our institutions are celebrating their silver jubilee. At the outset, let me briefly recount the success story of Sheshadripuram Group of Institutions. This organization had its beginning in 1930 when two visionary ladies, Srimati Anandamma and Srimati Sitamma, opened a small school for girls at Sheshadripuram in Bangalore. In the course of the past 87 years, the Sheshadripuram Group has established itself as one of the foremost educational organizations of Karnataka, with 33 institutions in its fold, employing 1,300 staff and molding 21,000 students in its institutions, providing educational opportunities from pre-primary to post-graduation and research. Eminent students have passed out of our institutions and they are now in high positions in every walk of life. Indeed, in the educational scenario, our institutions have been deservedly described as islands of excellence. Our mission statement affirms that every individual from each stratum of society deserves affordable, relevant, and quality education. We constantly strive to fulfill this social obligation by inclusion and expansion of newer streams in our institutions and provision of world-class infrastructure. Our ultimate goal is to nurture knowledge that will lead to happiness, peace, harmony, and prosperity. On a solemn occasion like this, I remember with gratitude our founders, past presidents, secretaries, and trustees and staff who have contributed their mite to the spread of meaningful education in the last 87 years. I have now the great honor of introducing our eminent guest, though His Holiness is too famous a personality to need an introduction, and my words are too inadequate to measure up to his greatness. His Holiness the 14th Dalai Lama was born Tenzing Gyatso on 6th July 1935 at Ando, which straddles between Tibet and China. Enthroned as the Lama on 22nd February 1940, he assumed temporal power over his country on 17th November 1950. Political developments in Tibet forced him to flee to India at the age of 15, along with 80,000 of his countrymen on 30th March 1959, and to establish his domain at Dharmashala, known as Little Lhasa. He continues to travel across the world, spreading his message of peace and compassion, non-violence and religious harmony. He has created a Tibetan educational system to ensure that the Tibetan history, language and culture are passed on from generation to generation, a Tibetan Institute of Performing Arts, a Central Institute of Higher Tibetan Studies, 200 monasteries and convents to preserve Buddhist teachings. He has got resolutions passed by the UN General Assembly to respect the human rights of Tibetans. He constantly speaks against nuclear proliferation. He engages in interfaith dialogue with other religious heads in order to dispel discord among religions. He is equally interested in science and its interface with Buddhism. He is concerned about ecology and environment, gender equality and women's rights, compassion for animals. At 82, His Holiness maintains a busy schedule of teaching, and his lectures are webcast across the world. He is the author of a number of books. His Holiness believes that Tibetan Buddhism is based on the Nalanda tradition. Indeed, his kinship to India is deep and enduring. He considers Mahatma Gandhi as his spiritual guru and mentor. He says, "I am Tibetan in appearance, but an Indian in spirituality." The awards conferred on His Holiness are too numerous to be listed. I shall but mention only a few. Ramon Magsaysay Award 1959, Nobel Peace Prize 1989, Freedom Medal 1994, Congressional Gold Medal 2007, Templeton Prize 2012, Doctor of Letters from the University of Minnesota, Doctor of Humane Letters, McAllister College, and the like. It is highly ennobling to listen to the Nobel Peace Prize acceptance speech of His Holiness. Let me quote a few sentences. "All problems must be solved through dialogue, through talk. The use of violence is outdated and never solves problems. Killing people in the name of religion is unthinkable, very sad. We all share this small planet. We have to learn to live in harmony and peace with each other and with nature. Truth is the only weapon we possess. Develop a sense of brotherhood and sisterhood, love and compassion, a sense of universal responsibility, not only in the geographical sense, but also in respect to the different issues that confront our planet. True peace can be achieved only through mental peace," unquote. The Nobel lecture ends with the beautiful words, "For as long as space endures, and for as long as living beings remain, until then may I too abide to dispel the misery of the world. Your Holiness, it is my privilege and pride to welcome you." I request our beloved President Shri Pandit Aradhya to kindly offer him the bouquet of flowers as a token of our love and gratitude. Please give a big hand. Friends, we are indeed extremely fortunate for the presence and participation of Sri Thupten Chopel, Chief Representative of Tibet South Zone. I welcome him wholeheartedly. We have a very distinguished guest today, Padma Shri A.S. Kiran Kumar, an internationally renowned space scientist, researcher, science communicator, and currently chairman, Indian Space Research Organization. The name of Padma Shri Aloru Seelin Kiran Kumar is synonymous with the space odyssey of India in a league with the pioneer Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Shri Kiran Kumar was born on 22nd October 1952 at Hassan and had his education at National College, Bangalore and the Indian Institute of Science, all in Bangalore. Starting his career at Space Application Center, Ahmedabad, Shri Kiran Kumar has reached the helm of ISRO for the ambitious space programs of our country, Chandrayaan and Mangalyaan. Shri Kiran Kumar developed key scientific instruments. It is no surprise, therefore, that Shri Kiran Kumar has received prestigious awards from space and scientific establishments across the world. Indian Society of Remote Sensing Award 1994, Vaswik Award 1998, Astronautical Society of India Award 2001, ISRO Award 2006, Bhaskara Award 2007, ISRO Team Achievement Award 2008, and Honorary PhD from Geetham University. Shri Kiran Kumar is a Fellow of National Academy of Engineers and member of International Academy of Astronautics. In recognition of his contributions to our space research and space programs, the Government of India conferred on him the Padma Shri Award. Sir, it is my privilege to welcome you to this program. I request our President Shri Pandita Raja to do the honors. Please give him a big hand. The president of this function is Shri N.R. Panditaradhya, fondly respected as the head of the Sheshadripuram family. Hailing from an illustrious family of social workers, philanthropists and entrepreneurs, Shri Panditaradhya has brought rich experience, sterling qualities of humility and spirituality, and unswerving commitment to the building of several educational, charitable and religious institutions. We are constantly guided by the wise counsel of our president. Sir, it is befitting that person of your values and magnanimity is presiding over this function today. Sir, I welcome you to this function. Sheshadripuram Institutions is guided by a dedicated team of past and present office bearers, trustees, and life members. Their one-point agenda is how to take this organization to greater and greater heights. They are all present here in full capacity, and it is my pleasure to welcome them today. Distinguished vice chancellors, deans, professors, principals of various prestigious schools and colleges, numbering over 219 eminent educationists, scientists, engineers, lawyers, chartered accountants, IT professionals, and men and women from all walks of life are present in this August gathering. I extend a warm welcome to each one of them. Sheshadripuram Institutions are headed by committed academics and assisted by experienced and qualified faculty and staff members. I welcome you all. I extend a hearty welcome to government officials, the personal staff of His Holiness, the 14th Dalai Lama, particularly Sri Tempa Shering, Chief Private Secretary to His Holiness, the secretariat staff of the Chairman ISRO, media fraternity, photographers, police and intelligence personnel, and above all, our alumni, students and their parents who have responded to our invitation overwhelmingly and are present today in large numbers. My special welcome to the conveners of this remarkable initiative, Principal Dr. S. N. Venkatesh, Professor Santanu Das, Professor Salma Banu, Shri Madhu and Shri Ranjan Abraham, and team of White Petals, and to all the heads of our institutions who have toiled day in and day out to make this historic lecture meet possible. Yallarigu mattomme aadarada swagata suswagata.